everyone, this is Flo here, and welcome back to another video. And this has been a topic that some of you might not have noticed, but a lot of my followings and subscriptions have actually did notice the topic. And I saw that people were struggling to understand what lies for Senpa Bay and how did she manage to end up in such a situation. So I was thinking to do a summary of the rise and fall of Senpai Bay. Senpai Bay is a Filipino gachetuber who is 12 years old, and according to her about page, she started out on the 26th of July 2021, which is actually very recent for such an amount of subscriber counts. With her rising influence with her many Squid Game videos, her original OC, as well as the Flying Pig, she was able to rise on the top and have her own spot in the Gacha Rewind 2021. So then, what happened? 2022 was just starting and everything was going smoothly for a good beginning for the Gacha community. And how was she able to turn things upside down and make people absolutely be revolted of what she did? So let's talk about Senpai Bay's first mistake, the whitewashing of the Encanto characters. Encanto is a very good movie representing a family, the Colombian cultural background, and actually more representation of people of colors. Well, here, the problem is, we actually don't know if Senpai Bay actually watched the movie, but all the characters she used are pretty much whitewashed. So when pretty much everyone started to call her out for her whitewashing, she then decided to make her second mistake, lie. And how did she lie? By blaming the software she used, basically CapCut. And absolutely everyone saw through the lie and she pretty much blew herself over. And she tried again and again to say that it wasn't her fault, she wasn't to blame, that she did correctly the characters, but it was CapCut. CapCut was basically the problem. And everyone saw the lie. All the people using CapCut, including me, saw the lie. And then she tried to apologize. And most people of color here that I talked with about this topic didn't forgive her. And basically her apology, now deleted, was maybe not sincere, according to me. It was sort of half-assed. And everything was like all about herself and not about the actions she's done. So yeah, it was pretty much a BS apology. But then, death threats come in, because obviously when someone is quote-unquote cancelled, there is always people putting the cherry on top and starting sending death threats to people. And, well, those people basically accused Senpai Bay to actually fake her quote-unquote depression and self-harm. And that's where ladies, gentlemen, and neutral friends, that will have to add a trigger warning to self-harm. So afterwards, that's when she made her third mistake, and this time not related to the whitewash. This time she made a community post basically saying that for those who don't believe that I'm pretty much doing self-harm, here is proof. And thing is, when you put a picture in community post without censoring stuff, well, it pretty much blew up everything over. People were revolted, people were getting triggered, and even if she put a trigger warning up, the first thing you actually see is not the trigger warning message, it's actually the picture itself. So the trigger warning here was pretty much useless. I was sleeping at the time, and when I woke up and I saw so many community posts saying, I hate you, I freaking hate you, I was like, okay, what the fuck did she do? Of course, now everything that I'm talking about has been completely wiped out of her channel, and there's only one community post remaining, quote-unquote her last apology, because now she's quitting. So now that you basically know everything, let's summarize what she did. So first off, she whitewashed, which made her seem a bit racist towards people of colors. Then she lied that she whitewashed. And at this point, when she tried to apologize, people were accepting her quote-unquote apology, but they were still pretty shocked that she tried to escape through lies. And the third mistake is the showing cuts part. And that pretty much triggered a lot of people. And she shouldn't have done that. I mean, if you want to prove that you're basically self-harming, that's actually not a way, especially showing the cuts, you could have at least censored. But overall, that's it. If you have to learn something about this situation, is that if you ever do one single mistake, your career can be blown over after 1 week. And you have to be mentally stable enough to stay on this platform. If you feel like it's too much for you, you're not made for the YouTube career. If you feel like hate comments, criticizing comments, and people calling you out for your mistakes are way too much for you, definitely not for you. That's all for this video / podcast. I'm very sorry about the editing. It's pretty much early in the morning, and I wanted to make a video that was actually complete enough to summarize the whole situation. And I think that's pretty much it. I wish you all a good day or a good night, and stay safe outside or on the internet. Thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. Goodbye, everyone.